Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Mani Shresth from Haryana School of Business, GJ University of Science and Technology, Hisar. Today we are going to talk on module Employment Applications and Resume Writing from the paper Business Communication. Let's have a look on various learning objectives. First is to understand the relevance of employment application. Then, to know about writing a persuasive employment application letter, followed by to know about designing a professional resume. An employment application letter is also known as a cover letter. It is a document sent with your resume to provide additional information on your skills and experience. Writing an employment application is probably your first interaction with formal business writing. An employment application provides an opportunity to the applicant to impress a prospective employer. It is an accompanying letter to a resume. It helps in creating a distinct position of applicant in the mind of an employer. Basically, it differentiates you from other applicants. A well-written employment application can lead an employer to go through your resume and increase the chances of you getting an offer. Before starting any activity to write an employment application or creating a resume, it is very important to do a self-analysis. It is done prior to drafting a cover letter. A self-analysis is an exercise for answering the question, "Who are you?" Generally, we are having a feeling that we always know everything about us. But many a times, we are only having a surface awareness about us. While writing a cover letter, we must get deeper information on the areas like skills, interests, and personal values held by us. A good self-analysis can help you in better projecting yourself in front of an employer and hence getting closer to the job offer. So, know yourself includes knowing about your personality traits, knowing about your education, knowing about your skill set, knowing about your experience. After that, a letter of application can be written. A letter of application has a special relevance which differentiates it from other forms of letters. It possesses all the qualities of a persuasive sales letter. In this case, the only difference is here the product is you. And a sales letter under the application is trying to convince the prospective employer to buy you as a product. Just like in sales letter, you should present the features of the product that might appeal the reader. You should also mention about the benefit the prospective employer will get after selecting you. Now, there are different types of employment applications. Type 1 includes and mentions everything about you, such as qualification, skill, experience, personal information, etc. This kind of employment application is generally detailed and lengthy, and it describes about the prospect in detail. As the employers are having lesser time available with them, sometimes this type of employment application irritates them and many times they just discard it. To avoid, we can consider second type of employment application, which is divided into two parts, a brief application and a detailed resume. In the brief application, reference of the job advertisement along with your most significant attributes related to the job is mentioned. A resume provides detailed information about your personal profile, skill set, experience, achievement, references, etc. Before drafting an application letter, it is important to understand various parts of its structure. Under the structure, an application letter is having six parts. First is applicant's address and date, employer's name and address, salutation, main content, closing and signature, and finally enclosures. Let's see all these components one by one. Under the applicant's address, the address of the person who is writing the employment application should be mentioned at the top of the application. It is always important to mention the complete address to avoid any kind of ambiguity. The address should be in line with the left margin of the letter. While writing date in an employment application, it is important to use correct format. Now, the question is, what is a correct format? Generally, we write date casually in our applications, like 24 July 2002, July 24, 02, 24th JUL 2002, and so many ways we are writing a date. But a correct format is something which is predefined. For example, here the date is written, first you have to write the complete name of month followed by a space, then you have to write the date followed by a comma, then followed by the complete year. In our case, it is July 24, 2002. Similarly, September 2, 2002. If you wish to write date first, then you have to put TH before that, after that, like 24th July 2002. So it is important to use a correct format. You should write employer's name and address by providing at least two spaces below the date. You should also left align the whole matter of the employer's name and address. You should also correctly spell the name and designation of the employer. It is very important because a mistake of misspelled names can be fatal for your chances of getting a job. A salutation describes how you are greeting the receiver of the application. There are various ways to greet people, but under an employment application, you have to be very careful while giving a salutation. First and foremost thing is always provide a salutation. Then it is preferable to write Dear Sir or Ma'am as compared to writing Dear Mr. Sehgal or Dear Ms. Sharma, because you are not aware of the receiver. You have not interacted earlier to the receiver of the application. So it is always advisable to use Dear Sir or Dear Ma'am. Main content in the letter should be written as per the guidelines of writing effective letters. Broadly, matter need to be organized, sequenced, checked grammatically, include vital information, and properly formatted. While writing this part, it is important to check whether we are using a detailed or brief format. After that, there is a time for closing. An application letter must drive for action in the end. Also, a compliment should be added in the end. The complimentary close must go with the salutation. For example, yours faithfully, yours respectfully, yours truly are the more popular complimentary closes. But the usage of sincerely or sincerely yours is preferred during formal communication. At the end of the letter, there is a place for signature. A signature is distinctively marking the name of the applicant in ink on a paper. Below a signature, name of the applicant is mentioned. Nowadays, digital signatures can be created and used. Enclosures are mentioned below the signature and name of the applicant. It indicates the list of documents that are attached with the application letter. Generally, the document and the type 2 application is your resume. Enclosures can be mentioned in short as ENCL, and list of documents attached is mentioned in front of it. If you are having more than one document, you can provide a list by putting serial number before each document. Now let's take a look on a format of your application letter. In this picture, we can easily see that all the components of application letter structures are being included. At the top of the letter, you are having address of the applicant, address lines, place, pin code, followed by date. Then there is a spacing, followed by employee's name and address. Then there is salutation, then main body or the main content of your letter, followed by a complimentary clause, then your signature and name. At the end of your letter, you can easily see that list of documents are attached as a part of enclosures. Once we are aware with the structure of a letter, we have to develop the message for application letter. The content developed for the message must be properly organized and presented in the application letter. For that, a logical approach is followed. The total content is divided into three parts: opening, middle, and end. Every part is having its own relevance. Purpose of an opening letter is to gain attention of the reader. Middle part of the letter mentions about the data and details of the applicant, while the end part of the letter puts a request by you asking for an action. We can have a better look about these three parts in our next slides. An application letter must have an attention gainer opening. This is the introductory paragraph of the letter. It must bear all the qualities of a sales letter. It is worthy to remember that receiver of the letter might be of senior position and very busy. So your writing must gain desirable attention right from the beginning. Let's have a look on few attractive openings for an employment letter. Stan Consulting and RR Capitals. Both these companies provided me a chance to prove my ability in the field of portfolio management. For last 1 year, I am working for JJ Finance, where I am heading a financial restructuring team responsible for optimization of investments in Southeast Asia. Another example, please refer to your advertisement number AAJ456 in the Times of India, dated September 6, 2002, for the post of copywriter. I wish to be considered for this post. Now, these examples highlights that if we are using such kind of language and we are starting our employment application letter with these kind of startings, it straight away attracts the attention of the reader. The middle paragraph of application letter is known as informative middle paragraph. This part of the application letter is used to provide a justification and proof of what you have claimed in the attractive opening paragraph. It acts like a persuasive paragraph. While mentioning any information in this paragraph, an applicant must take care about connecting the information with the requirements of the advertised job. The reason being, the employer would be interested in knowing those specific qualities in the applicant which are essential and desirable for the completion of a job. In this paragraph, do not forget to highlight your achievements and performances. Such information might lead the prospective employer to your resume for details of contributions. You can also present the information related to your education, work experience, interest areas, and personal qualities. Now consider few examples for informative middle paragraph. In my major, I studied marketing with a specialization in consumer behavior. My CGPA indicates effort put in by me, especially during the research project on perceptual mapping of mobile service providers in the National Capital Region. Another is, I got a black belt certification for training program on Six Sigma, proving my proficiency in handling quality related issues. Another way of writing is, in addition to the above achievements, I am a team player and gel very well in diverse environments. With these examples, we can see that we can put maximum information which is attractive for the reader. The end paragraph of your application letter is known as action-oriented end paragraph. The end part of the application letter must lead to the action proposed in the close. Decision about the action sought is totally at the discretion of the applicant. Depending upon the purpose, a desired action can be driven. An action could be a request for a meeting, an invitation to discuss further, asking for a reference check, etc. It is not advisable to request for offering an employment in the first communication. The action words should be clear and specific. You should not sound too aggressive or pushy while closing the letter. Also, end paragraphs must present information related to your contact details, such as email address and phone number. Here are some of the examples for your end paragraph. Remember, end paragraph must include what you wish from the reader and you must mention your contact details. Now look at the example. These brief facts and the detailed information in my resume justify my suitability to the job of operations manager. Please let me know a suitable time and place for further discussions on the issue. You can contact me at this number during weekdays to arrange for a meeting. Another example, my educational qualification and experience have equipped me to work as an operations manager in your organization. May I meet with you to further discuss about how I can contribute more to your organization as an operations manager? You can email me at this given address or call me at the given number to arrange an interview. So as we see from these examples, it is having all the components for an effective closing paragraph. Now consider the example of an application letter. In this example, we can clearly see that how the rules of the structure of application letter has been followed, plus how the message is being developed and divided into various parts. At the top of the letter, we can see the address of the applicant, date, address and name of the employer, salutation, then a clear-cut opening paragraph which says 5 years of experience at J&R Limited, a leading name in FMCG sector, as assistant marketing manager makes me qualified enough to apply for the post of marketing manager you advertised in the Times of India of April 30, 2008. Now this particular paragraph clearly attracts the attention of a reader. After that, a middle paragraph is explaining the worth of the applicant for his and the suitability of the applicant for the job. In the end paragraph, we can see that in short, sir, both my education qualification and my experience have equipped me to work as a marketing manager in your organization. May I meet you with to further discuss about how I can contribute more to your organization as a marketing manager? You can email me at the given email address and contact number to arrange an interview. Now, this highlights the contact details and the expectation of the applicant from the employer. And the letter closes with your signature, name, and enclosure mentioning your latest resume. Many times we confuse the terms resume, curriculum vitae, and biodata. Let's see what are these terms and how these are different. A resume is a summary document that provides information regarding your education, work experience, skill set, etc. It is generally used to highlight specific competency for a given job opportunity. On the other hand, a curriculum vitae is a more comprehensive and detailed document when compared with a resume. So we can say that it is lengthier than a resume. On the other hand, biodata is defined as one's life and work experiences. The focus of biodata is on providing personal details such as date of birth, height, weight, color of skin, photograph, and nationality. The term biodata is more traditional for corporate sector as compared to resume or curriculum vitae. Preparation of a resume involves collecting the relevant information pertaining to the applicant and arranging it in a logical and aesthetic manner. The information is related to applicant's career objective, work experience, education, personal qualities, personal information, skill set, and references. Each of the information should be arranged in a reverse chronological manner. It facilitates the reader to know your work experience or education from present to past. There are various ways and formats to present the information about the applicant, and you can choose any of the format that suits your requirement. An example of one of the format is shown here to present the information about an applicant. First, an applicant is required to provide personal information related to the address of the applicant. At the top of your resume, you can mention your name, address, and contact. As we can see in the slide, that name is followed by the complete address of the applicant, followed by the contact details in the form of landline phone number, mobile phone number, and email address of the applicant. Then you can mention the objective for which you have applied. The objective here is mentioned by the applicant is to get a senior position in quality assurance that will lead to independently heading operations in e-business. Then you can mention the objective for which you have applied. The objective here is mentioned by the applicant is to get a senior position in quality assurance that will lead to independently heading operations in e-business. Then you can mention your work experience in a summarized form. Here the work experience is shown 9+ years. The various fields under which the applicant has got the work experience are quality assurance, inspection, global sourcing operation management. It also specifies that how the applicant has worked so far. That means the applicant has worked with liaison office, production house, buying company, retail, third-party inspection, e-commerce company. There are various ways to present your work experience in a summarized form. You can choose any of the way that suits you. After that, you have to provide detailed experience and the major responsibilities and achievements that you have gained so far. With this example, we can see that the applicant has an experience from July 10 till date. He has worked with the company RSD Private Limited, which is located in Mumbai. The position held by the applicant is Head General Manager Quality Assurance. During the tenure of the applicant with this company, the applicant is managing the private label quality assurance department with 8 QA executives to ensure desired quality product from different factories across India and Bangladesh. Reviewing and evaluating approval of pre-production and sealer samples for private label styles and so on. At the end of this slide, we can see that key highlights under this job is the applicant is awarded Gem of the Year Award Best Manager in January 2015. Similarly, it is important to mention the educational background. You can choose this particular format to mention the educational background, first mentioning the duration of your program, then the organization from where you have studied, followed by the location of the organization. So here the time duration is from 2004 to 2006, National Institute of Fashion Technology, and the location is Bangalore. And the program that the applicant has completed is Postgraduate Diploma in Garment Manufacturing Technology. And this information is followed by the grades the applicant got. That means the qualification the application is having. Then it is important to mention various trainings and proficiency the applicant is having. Here an example is the trainings are four trainings are mentioned at different duration and in different years at different location. Same format has to be followed. First you have to mention the duration, then organization and the location. At the end of the slide we can see that there is a column for computer proficiency. If you are having hands-on knowledge about the computer, you can mention your skills here. Then it must include your personal profile, which includes information like date of birth, languages known, marital status, interest area, countries visited, and so on. And at the end of your resume, you should always mention references. Now, it is a personal choice whether to mention references here or to be given at a later stage. For example, here it is mentioned that personal and professional references will be gladly furnished on request. So, students, let's now summarize what we have learned in this module. An effective cover letter creates a good first impression on prospective employer. Doing a self-assessment is imperative for creating an effective resume. An employment application letter should be written as per the format. A cover letter should lead a reader to the resume. While drafting a cover letter, opening should be attention-getting. Then a detailed middle paragraph should be given. And in the end paragraph, it is very important to write what you are expecting from the reader. For example, you might wish for arrangement of a meeting or an interview or a general discussion. Also, in the end paragraph, you have to give your contact details like phone number, email ID, so that whatever you are wishing or requesting in your application letter, the reader can contact you for that. Resume must include education, skill set, experience, and personal detail. Remember, a resume is different from a curriculum vitae and a bio data. An attractive resume can bring an applicant closer to the final placement.